So stop putting the ownership on the victim. Rather, put it on the abusers and the oppressors who did this to her and countless women that this is happening to across the globe.
Way of life as cute. Keeping it 100.
Assalamu alaikum, welcome back to my YouTube channel. Today's video is going to be about Isra Ghareeb being victim blamed for her own honor killing. So if you don't know already, Isra Ghareeb was a 21-year-old Palestinian young lady who was killed in an honor killing just a few days ago by her own family, specifically her father and the men of that family. More details about that, please click the link right here and watch my previous video so you could be fully caught up with what's going on. You see, this is very typical behavior and belief amongst the men in the Muslim community. Now, this is not every man in the Muslim community, yet there are still these random place annoying men who find it appropriate to post things like this, saying comments like,
"Well, she was with a non-mahram at the time,"
or trying to distract us from the truth by saying,
we have to wait till all the facts come out."
And unfortunately, there's some men who behave and act like she had it coming. Either way, Muslim men amongst us somehow believe that the real issue isn't the honor killing, it's how she carried herself, or perhaps the decision she made, or the fact that we need a little more information before we judge the situation. The truth is, you're distracted and distracting the ummah from finding a solution about this problem. The issue isn't if she was honor killed or not. The issue is that those honor killings are still taking place, yet you have your head so high up within your backside that you can't see that it's a problem. We want to neglect the issue and act like honor killings aren't happening. Yes, honor killings aren't from Islam, but they're still taking place in the name of Islam, and that needs to be addressed and dealt with. You can't hide under the covers and under the bed and act like the boogeyman or the monster doesn't exist. These are problems amongst the Muslims, and we gotta be direct talking about them. But you're here making straw men and distracting us from seeking solutions to the truth by saying stupid comments to distract the regular people from finding solutions to these honor killings and waking up the Muslim men to stand up for women and their rights. But you're here busy posing stupid questions at the wrong time, saying things like,
"How do we know this even happened? We need some evidence."
Wallahi, thinking like that will never solve the problem. Thinking like this is what the other media does when it comes to gun control. Whenever there's some type of gun violence in America, the issue is never gun control. The issue is always something else and deviated from the truth.
We need to protect kids, and that means we've got to have metal detectors. We've got to have experienced cops. I don't care if they're retired or they're still cops working in the schools, and we've got to be able to have perimeter controls.
We should start thinking about arming teachers.
A minimum of 6 to 8 teachers and administrators who are trained in the use of firearms.
It's an issue of not enough superior firepower to stop these killers.
Self-defense classes are the best thing for a kid. So it's time that we actually think about this rationally and go, how do you improve upon this? Well, you train them. Learning combat, learning hand-to-hand combat.
Someone's decided I'm going to commit this crime. They'll find a way to get the gun to do it. That doesn't mean you shouldn't have a law that makes it harder. It just means understand, to be honest, it isn't going to stop this from happening.
That's what you and I are doing when we don't talk face on with these issues. We have to acknowledge that these are problems in our society and amongst cultural Muslims. This is an issue, and by you closing your eyes and distracting us with these stupid, unnecessary, unempathetic comments, you're not helping. In fact, you're causing more problems. This is the type of thinking that causes problems to never be solved. The actual issue is the fact that these things still happen. It's not a matter of if it really happened to her or not. It's about it's still happening in today's day and age in the name of Islam amongst jahil, old school, cultural thinking, coward Muslims that live amongst us. The fact that men still think like this.
إذا قلت لها أنت ممنوع هي قررت تروح تشتغل لأنه بنهي أنت عندك رأي بس هيدي حياتها هي
بطخها فهي أعملها
يعني بطخها
يعني بموتها
ومن بيعطيك هذا الحق؟
أبوي وإخواني وأمامي وقرايبي
بتشوف هذا الحق ما بشوفه خطأ جدا لأنه أنت كيف لك ممكن تقتل حدا؟
لا مش غلط حقها وعرضنا يا زلمة شو مالك؟
لا عم تحكي مزح ولا عم تحكي جد؟
لا جد والله جد
بس الوضع مش مضحك لأنه هي لحق كمان تتصرف مثل ما بدها
ممنوع يا زلمة
The fact that if a woman goes through some type of sexual abuse or violence, the first thought is,
well, I wonder what she did wrong.
Like, what? Like, how is that the issue? The issue is that we feel entitled enough to think that this can't even happen in our society. The truth is, you're avoiding the issue when we actually don't address it, and you're creating straw men to distract us from actually finding solutions. Because guess what? If the men amongst the ummah are not focusing their time on upholding women's rights and fighting for their rights to uphold whatever Allah has blessed them with and ordained for them, fighting on their behalf to make sure that we amongst the men are upholding their rights and that women are educated about the rights that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given them, and there's going to be other groups who fight for women's rights, and they're not going to be doing it Islamically. So stop putting the ownership on the victim, rather put it on the abuse and the oppressors who did this to her and countless women that this is happening to across the globe. Because when we address the issue and when we acknowledge that it's a problem, that's the only time we will ever find a solution. Which is all kind of guys for watching. I appreciate you. Make sure you drop your comments and your feedback in the comment section below. Please make a dua for Isra and please share this message. Share this amongst each other, guys, so that people are educated about this issue and how this is a problem in our society and we have to deal with it and tackle it head on. I appreciate you watching. And until next time, I'm out.